In this lesson, you'll learn how to create great screencast videos. Whether you're creating application tutorials on your computer or doing a slideshow with a voiceover, I'll show you my best practices. So let's head over to the computer and see how I do it.
Tip number one is to use the right software. There are free options out there. For PC, Mac, and Linux users, OBS Studio is a free option that allows you to do screen recording. On a Mac, QuickTime Player allows you to record the screen. Just go up to File, New Screen Recording. You can even do New Movie Recording and New Audio Recording. If you're looking for a more professional option, Camtasia is the perfect application for you. It's great for PC and Mac users. Basically, you can record your screen, a webcam, and audio, and it's automatically synced when it comes into the video editor, which is part of Camtasia. It's easy to add titles, annotations, and zoom in and out of your screen with Camtasia. Another option for Mac users is ScreenFlow, which basically does the same thing. The next tip is to clean up your screen. Close any tabs that you don't need, close any windows or projects you're working on, and clean up your desktop. One thing you can do is just create a new folder on your desktop, name it whatever you want, and then put all the files on your desktop into that folder. Or you can just right-click and say clean up selection if you have a bunch of things on your desktop that you don't want to move around, because your desktop will automatically at least look a little bit more organized. If you're recording web browsers, go up to View, Enter Full Screen. This will clean up your web browser, make sure that you don't see the tabs or any of your favorite bookmarks at the top. Also, if you're doing a PowerPoint presentation or another slideshow, make sure that you open it up in full screen before you record. The other option is zooming in after the fact and cropping out what you don't want to see. My last tip is to make sure things are going to be at the right size. I'm recording my monitor, which is a 27-inch 2560 by 1440 pixel screen. It's easy to see things for me, but I know a lot of people are going to be watching my screencasts on their mobile phones or on their laptops or tablets. So one thing you can do when you're recording a website is to zoom in. On a Mac, just press Command Plus. On a PC, it would be Control Plus or minus to zoom in on the text in this website. Now it's much easier to see what I'm doing on the website. If you're recording something that's not on a web browser and you want to make things appear bigger, you can actually decrease the resolution of your display. Here I'm on a Mac, but you can also do this in the control panel of a PC. If you go to Display, Scaled, I can scale down my screen. What this does is it makes everything appear larger. If I'm doing a tutorial of an application like Premiere Pro here at full resolution, all of the buttons and the text, it looks very small. Imagine watching this on a mobile device. Maybe you are right now. Everything's going to look so small. You won't be able to see what I'm doing if I'm clicking around. By actually decreasing the resolution of my screen, everything gets bigger for you when you actually watch it. I can upscale my recording, which will be at 1600 by 900 to 1920 by 1080, so it's still an HD video. You don't want to go down too far, because if you decrease your screen resolution too far and then upscale it in post, you will lose some quality. But I would argue that being able to see the buttons and what I'm doing more clearly outweighs what you lose in sharpness by recording at the highest resolution possible. So those are my screen recording tips. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in another video.